Well, we just got a ton of information out of a supply chain analyst for Apple about what products Apple is going to be launching upcoming in September, guys. A ton of new features coming to some of these products, new Macs, new iPads, iPhones, Apple Watches, the whole deal. We got a ton of information on it that has just been leaked here. So I kind of want to go through all this with you guys. I want to kind of give you my opinion on all these different changes that are coming up to the products. Some big changes for a few of the different products, and I'll kind of give you my opinion there. Hope you guys really enjoy this. This is Regular Guy Tech. I am Jeremy. Let's get into this. Apple is reportedly upgrading most of its Mac lineup this fall, including the Mac Mini, which I'm pretty excited about. I'm thinking about getting a Mac Mini this upcoming fall, especially, you know, a newer one with better chips and whatnot, along with bigger Apple Watches, bezel-less iPads, and the long-awaited launch of AirPower. Apple supply chain analyst Ming-Chi Kuo of TF International Securities has published in his research note of predictions for Apple's fall lineup, and it's a doozy according to 9to5Mac. Koo claims that in addition to the three new iPhone models already rumored to launch, Apple will also update most of its Mac and MacBook lineups, including the long-suffering Mac Mini. He also says Apple will introduce new bezel-less Face ID iPads. We'll talk about that. Updated Apple Watch with bigger displays and a release of new pair of AirPods and AirPower wireless charger that was announced last year, all right? So basically, we're talking about this is the type of year where Apple just updates pretty much everything across the board, okay? They're like, we're just updating everything. Some years, Apple would kind of just update a few new products. Like, iPhone always gets updated. There's always a new iPhone. Some years, they won't even update the iPad. It'll just be the same old iPads and whatnot. This year, it sounds like they're going to literally update everything across the board, pretty much. So first off, iPhones. There's still the three iPhone rumor coming around that they're going to release three different iPhones. One model is expected to be kind of the same iPhone 10 model, which was a 8-inch OLED screen. Then they're talking about a 6.5-inch iPhone X Plus, okay, iPhone 10 Plus OLED model. And then they're also talking about a 6.1-inch, which is like a mid-range LCD model that could borrow the Face ID and the bezel-less design and whatnot of iPhone 10, but at a lower price point they're talking about. So Apple's really trying to, you know, go completely with their iPhone lineup just to the kind of bezel-less look and whatnot. They're also trying to go to something that would be a little more affordable. As we know, iPhone 10 this past year, it came out and it was at $1,000. And for most people, it's kind of a little out of their budget. The higher end iPhone 10 was like $1,150 we're talking about. You know, to some people, that's just a little pricey, right? You know, maybe it's one thing to afford $600 or $700, but when you're talking about $1,000 plus, you know, and then you gotta add on the taxes on top of that, because the bigger the amount, the bigger the taxes on top. It's a lot of money there. So they're trying to go three different models this year, and that 6.5-inch, that should be very interesting to see what price point that comes out in at. I wouldn't be surprised if a 6.5-inch starts well over $1,000. We're talking about starting model, the more, you know, if you want a ton of memory in that, we might be talking about, you know, $1,200 to $1,400 for that one, guys. So very interesting. They're trying to hit all the different price points there. As far as Macs go, who claims that the MacBook, MacBook Pro, iMac, and the Mac Mini are all slated for upgrades this fall, presumably with Intel's latest 8th generation core processor, guys. So we're talking about pretty much every single Mac you could possibly want. They're talking about, you know, upgrading them all. Now, there's not as much information about whether there will be design changes, which there may not be any design changes. It might just be better specs for all these Macs and whatnot, which is good, because I can just tell you I'm definitely in the market for a Mac. I'm thinking about getting a Mac Mini. What do you guys think I should get? I already have MacBook Air. We have several MacBook Airs, so I don't really want a new MacBook Air. I'm thinking about just getting a new Mac Mini if it has phenomenal specs, and then just getting my own monitors and whatnot. Let me know what you guys think down there. What should I get? MacBook Air, they're talking about, in addition to the spec boost mentioned above, Koo says that Apple will finally replace the older MacBook Air with a new budget laptop model, although there's no real information on what it will look like. iPads, let's talk iPads for a second. New iPad Pro models are said to be in the works, both of which would have Face ID, all right? Face ID and an updated bezel-less design with no home button, just like iPhone X. Koo says two sizes are planned, the 12.9-inch and an 11-inch version, which may replace the 10.5-inch version. This is a 10.5-inch version of the iPad Pro right here. So it might just be slightly bigger, but if you kind of take out the bezels, it would make sense, right? I have a feeling this is going to push price points up even more, and I can just tell you, both those things are a complete waste. In my opinion, personally, I don't care about Face ID really at all, especially on an iPad. It just does not matter to me. Maybe on an iPhone, it makes a little more sense, but on an iPad, like, give me a break. It's worthless in my opinion. I'm using it at my desk most of the time. We're out on the couch, I don't need Face ID, all right? And the other part, bezel-less design, I can just tell you, like, even, you know, they've taken the bezels down a lot on the iPads over the year, and that's somewhat great, but it is a little annoying sometimes, because sometimes I'll, like, you know, have the iPad here or whatnot, and, you know, just part of my skin will maybe touch the iPad, and when I'm trying to surf up or whatever, it doesn't surf up, and then I have to kind of move it, or if my finger's just barely on it. If we're talking about no bezels, this could be a bigger issue, okay? Because it's already getting to be an issue with how small the bezels already are here. So, you know, to me, definitely not worth upgrading from my 10.5 inch to any of these new models. Even if the chips are faster, which I would expect them to maybe have faster chips. But remember, if they launch a new iPad with the Face ID, with bezel-less design, and with faster chips, man, these price points are really going to go up quite a bit on the iPad. So that should be a little scary there. Apple Watch. Two Apple Watch models are said to be getting slightly larger displays. The smaller 38mm model will reportedly jump from a 1.5-inch display to a 1.57-inch display, and the 42mm model will go from a 1.65-inch display to a 1.78-inch display, adding enhanced heart rate detection as well. There's no word yet about whether Apple will simply put the larger screens on the existing body of the watch or a more radical design to the watch layout. Interesting, okay? I don't personally own an Apple Watch out there. I would love to hear from you guys in that comment section. If you actually own an Apple Watch, do you use it all the time? Do you use it every day? Do you like the Apple Watch experience? I would love to hear from you guys in that comment section. I don't personally own one. Maybe someday I'll get to the point where I end up buying one of these. As of right now, they haven't interested me, okay? They just haven't interested me to go spend the $400 or whatever on getting one of these. But I would love to know from you guys in that comment section. Do you own one? Do you have any interest in getting one? It looks like they're going to try to make the displays bigger. One of the biggest things is I've always looked at is, like, it's another thing you got to worry about charging. Like, that's, like, probably my biggest worry about the Apple Watch is, like, dude, I got so many things I need to charge all the time between my different iPads, my iPhone, my Macs and whatnot. Like, there's just so much to charge constantly. And then I have to have a watch. I'd rather just, you know, own a regular watch. And yeah, it doesn't have the features of, oh, I can get my texts on here and emails and things like that. But at the same time, it's one less thing I have to worry about charging. So, but anyways, I want to know your guys' opinion on Apple Watch down there in the comments section. AirPower is officially supposed to finally start shipping this fall. AirPower, they announced it last year in the new iPhone X launch and whatnot. It never ended up coming out quite yet. Finally, it's supposed to come out, so I guess they'll make good on their promise that it was going to come out in 2018, which is their product that basically, you can charge something. You can charge the new iPhone X without actually having to plug it in, which is, you know, a new step for Apple because they haven't done something like that in the past. And the last new product they're supposed to be coming out with is AirPods. So AirPods, I think it's been, I want to say AirPods has been a little bit of a success. I think it's been a little bit of a thing for people to get used to, you know, headphones with no wires and whatnot, and it just kind of like dangles from your ears. It'll be very interesting to see what these AirPods are all about. They're talking about these are going to have much better noise cancellation. They're talking about waterproofing these. That is pretty cool. They're talking about, you know, pretty much across the board better performance of these AirPods. So I think the AirPods is really a device that could really take off in a major way for Apple. The question is, Can they get it to a point where they market it correctly and they have all the performance specs that, you know, somebody would demand in a product like this that you're spending $159 for? You know, phenomenal, like amazing sound, you know, just amazing everything across the board. Can they do that with AirPods and can they market it in the right way? If they can, I think this is a product that they can sell tens of millions of units a year with. The just question is, you know, can they get it to that level? So those are all the updates on what Apple is planning on coming out with in September, guys. Just a monstrous launch it's going to look like. It's going to be for a ton of different products across the board. I would love to hear from you guys in that comment section on any products you're specifically interested in buying from Apple coming up the next year. I would love to hear from you guys, as always, in that comment section. This is Regular Guy Tech. I am Jeremy. Thank you for watching. Have a great day.